In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, coming together as God's family, let us call to mind our sins and ask God's pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to the Father and to one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, how can any one of you, with a case against another, dare to bring it to the unjust for judgment, instead of to the holy ones? Do you not know that the holy ones will judge the world? If the world is to be judged by you, are you unqualified for the lowest law courts? Do you not know that we will judge angels? Then why not everyday matters? If, therefore, you have courts for everyday matters, do you sit as judges people of no standing in the church? I say this to shame you. Can it be that there is not one among you wise enough to be able to settle a case between brothers? But rather, brother goes to court against brother, and that before unbelievers. Now indeed, then it is in any case a failure on your part that you have lawsuits against one another. Why not rather put up with injustice? Why not rather let yourselves be cheated? Instead, you inflict injustice and cheat, and this to brothers. Do you not know that the unjust will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor boy prostitutes, nor sodomites, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor slanderers, nor robbers will inherit the kingdom of God. That is what some of you used to be, but now you have had yourselves washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and in the Spirit of our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
Let them praise His name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to Him with timbre and harp. For the Lord loves His people, and He adorns the lowly with victory.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all His faithful. Alleluia.
The Lord takes delight in His people. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus departed to the mountain to pray, and He spent the night in prayer to God. When day came, He called His disciples to Himself, and from them He chose 12, whom He also named apostles: Simon, whom He named Peter, and his brother Andrew; James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James the son of Alphaeus, Simon who was called a Zealot, and Judas the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. And He came down with them and stood on a stretch of level ground. A great crowd of His disciples and a large number of the people from all Judea and Jerusalem and the coastal region of Tyre and Sidon came to hear Him and to be healed of their diseases. And even those who were tormented by unclean spirits were cured. Everyone in the crowd sought to touch Him, because power came forth from Him and healed them all. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, my dear sisters and brothers. In today's Gospel, we heard the Lord choosing His 12 and giving them the title of apostles. It means that they are not only to be with them, eventually Jesus will send them. And the Lord could not have chosen a more controversial group of persons, a more diverse group of persons. Among the disciples chosen by the Lord, among the 12, there is a varying backgrounds. Some of them, like Peter and Andrew, were fishermen, while Matthew was a tax collector. Another, Simon, was a zealot, we could call makabayan o nationalists, baka nga pwede pang leftist. And yet they are together. They're together. Well, because the one who called them put them together in spite of coming from varying or different backgrounds. I think if we reflect on this, I have to say that the goal of the Lord is to bring us together. Just like in the church, just like in the parish, we come from different backgrounds. Some of you are born in Manila, others were born in provinces. Some of us are literate. Some even have college degrees. And some of our members in the parish or community have not probably even finished high school. Some believers are inclined to support this group of politicians. Others are supporting other group of politicians. So, iba't iba ang pinagmumula natin. Pero ang hamon sa atin ay ito, na sa kabila ng ating pagkakaiba, kay Kristo dapat tayo ay nagkakaisa. Jesus must be our source and reason for unity. Kasi kung sinasabi natin si Jesus ang ating sinusundan, pero ayaw naman nating kausapin ang ating kapwa, ayaw naman nating makatrabaho ang ating kapwa, ayaw naman nating tanggapin ang ating kapwa, duda ako kung talagang sinusundan natin si Kristo. Ang mga grupong nag-aaway-aaway ay dapat nagbabati-bati kay Kristo. Hindi ibig sabihin pareho tayo ng pananaw. It does not mean that we walk, well, simultaneously and in cadence. We may have different opinions about things, but we must be united in Christ. Pag lumabas po kayo, makakakita kayo ng mga karitela, no? May mga karitela sa labas. Yung gulong ng karitela, binubuo na iba't ibang bahagi, pero nakasentro sa gitna. Yun ay parang larawan ng pamayanan. Si Kristo ang sentro at ang lahat patungo sa iisang direksyon sa gitna. At mapapansin ninyo, habang napapalapit sa sentro yung distansya sa pagitan ng mga bahagi ay umiikli. Malayo sa sentro, malayo ang pagkakahiwalay. Pero habang lumalapit sa sentro, ang distansya ay dapat na umiikli. A very good picture of what should happen in a Christian community. The center is Christ, and the nearer we come to the center, the distance between us should be closer. That's the one. The second I would like to point out is this. Among the 12 chosen by the Lord, one would betray him. Another would deny him, and two will aspire for higher position. Siguro sabi natin, Lord, pipili ka rin lang, ito pa ang pinili mo, di ba? Pipili ka na rin lang, si Pedro pa ang pinili mo, si Judas Iscariote pa ang pinili mo, si San Juan at Santiago pa ang pinili mo, mga ambisyoso. Bakit hindi ka pumili ng banal, matalino, maayos? That's the wonder of God's call. Jesus called them not because they were holy. Jesus called them in spite of their imperfections. Jesus called them in spite of the fact that they are sinners. At ganun din tayo sa simbahan. Bakit ako ang pinili ng Diyos? Bakit kayo ang pinili ng Diyos? Bakit tayo ang tinawag? merong mas banal kaysa sa atin. Merong mas mabait kaysa sa atin. Bakit tayong pinili? Ganyan ang misteryo ng tawag ng Panginoon. Hindi niya tayo tinatawag kasi tayo ay mabait, mabuti, walang kasalanan. Sapagkat sa kabila ng ating kasalanan, sa kabila ng ating pagiging pasaway, ang tawag ng Diyos ay hindi nagbabago. And that is very mysterious. Why me? Perhaps the Lord will say, why not? Why not? And so, the only way we can respond to this is, Lord, salamat po. Kasi sa kabila ng pagiging ako, ay tinawag mo pa rin ako. Amen.
Please stand.
God calls His chosen ones to fulfill His will. Let us pray confidently to our Father, knowing that He wishes His people to intercede for the world. To every petition, our response would be, Father, hear us in Christ.
Father, hear us in Christ.
That the Church, through the Pope and Bishops, may lead us to the fullness of Christian life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, hear us in Christ. Christ.
That statesmen may guide our nation to the future stability and development of our nation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, hear us in Christ.
That we may persevere and be faithful in the vocation God has called us to undertake. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, hear us in Christ.
That the old, the sick, and the lonely may realize God's presence in their trials and difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, hear us in Christ.
That the dead may rest in the peace of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, hear us in Christ.
Almighty God, as we make these prayers, we come to do your will. Accept us in your beloved Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Creation through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, And by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.